Good evening, friends. So today, topic of discussion will be Pagets disease of the nipples, right? So Pagets disease of nipples, right? So today's topic will be Pagets disease of nipples. What is important in Pagets disease of nipples? But we have to understand this is one of the rare presentation of the breast cancer, right? Rare presentation of the breast cancer, which is responsible for 1 to 4% of breast cancers. So 1 to 4% of breast cancers will be presenting with Pagets disease of nipples. What is characteristic clinical feature? They will be presenting with pruritus and unilateral. So pruritus and unilateral erythematous eruption. Unilateral erythematous eruption, right? So unilateral erythematous eruption with scaly crust, right? So this is the presentation of a Pagets disease of nipples. So as I said, it's a rare presentation, 1 to 4%, and they will be presenting with pruritus and unilateral erythematous eruption with scaly crust. So this kind of presentation makes them a differential diagnosis for eczema. Right, so eczema will be also having similar kind of presentation when they will be involving nipples, but the difference is eczema will be bilateral and here you will be seeing unilateral presentation. So this is unilateral, eczema will be bilateral. So this is how we can differentiate one of the important differentiating feature between the Pagets disease of the nipple versus eczema. Eczema will be bilateral and they will be unilateral. So Pagets disease of nipple is unilateral erythematous eruption with scaly crust and pruritus, right? So this is the presentation, right? So what happens in Pagets disease? Usually these are ductal carcinoma in situ. These are ductal carcinoma in situ where tumor cells are inside the ductal system. So suppose I am showing you, this is the epidermis, this is the epidermis of the nipple and this is the ductal system, right? This is the ductal system and this is the epidermis, right? Epidermis is followed by a basement membrane. So suppose I am showing you, this is the basement membrane, this is the basement membrane. So what is happening in ductal carcinoma in situ? These are the tumor cells. So I am showing you, these are the tumor cells in duct. And these tumor cells, without crossing the basement membrane, so they are not crossing the basement membrane. So remember, they are not crossing the basement membrane by this way, right? So they are not crossing the basement membrane, without crossing the basement membrane. So what I am saying that ductal carcinoma in situ, tumor cells are entering into the epidermis. They are entering into the epidermis without crossing the basement membrane. So now we can see these are the tumor cells. So these are the tumor cells which are coming into the epidermis and there is no breaching of the basement membrane. So without crossing the basement membrane, they are entering through the lactiferous sinuses. And what happens? Because of entry of these tumor cells, if you look at the normal squamous epithelial cells, they are having epithelial barrier because of their tight connection. But due to interference, or you can say due to entry of the tumor cells, now you can see that there is a gap form between the epidermal squamous cell. Because of this gap formation between the epidermal squamous cell, extracellular fluid will be oozing out. So see, I'm showing you, this yellow color is extracellular fluid which is coming outside, and after coming outside they will be spread over the epidermis and this will be forming a scaly crust. So that is how a scaly crust will be formed, right? So there will be erythematous lesion and that erythematous lesion will be covered by a scaly crust. So that is characteristic of a Pagets disease, right? So this scaly crust, you can see what is the mechanism? ECF, that extracellular fluid is coming outside and they are getting deposited over the skin surface and they're forming a scaly crust. And you can see clinical examination, when you will see, this is the clinical examination of the Pagets disease of the breast. You can see the nipple here and you can see it's a erythematous lesion, right? So it's a erythematous lesion and there are scaly crust. So you can see here there is a scaly crust in this area, there is a scaly crust. So this is scaly crust is because of that extracellular fluid which is coming between the damaged barrier of this squamous epithelium. So that is why scaly crust we can see in this diagram, right? So that is how we can correlate the clinical presentation with the histological examination, right? So scaly crust, erythematous lesion, unilateral presentation, that is important for the Paget's disease of the breast, right? So this is about Paget's disease of the breast. When you will see a light microscopy, or you can say microscopic examination of the Paget's disease or Paget's tumor cells, so how it will be appearing? So suppose these are the normal cells. Paget cells will be larger cell, right? So what we have to understand, Paget cells will be, so how you will identify Paget cells? So Paget cells are larger cells, right? So this is how we have to understand, Paget cells are larger cells. So in comparison to the surrounding cell, when you will observe, they will be large, as you can see here, they are larger cells. And they will be having abundant and pale cytoplasm. So another important feature, they will be having abundant pale cytoplasm. So abundant pale cytoplasm will be there, and they will be having nucleus with prominent nucleoli. So they will be having nucleus with prominent nucleoli. So nucleus with prominent nucleoli. So nucleus with prominent nucleoli will be present in case of Paget's disease of the breast, right? So what is significance of this Paget's disease of the breast? So what we have to understand, 50 to 60% of the cases, they will be having underlying invasive carcinoma. So that is the clinical significance, right? So they will be having invasive carcinoma. So 50 to 60% of the cases, so 50 to 60% of the Paget's disease of the breast, they will be having underlying invasive carcinoma, right? So they will be having underlying invasive carcinoma, and these invasive carcinomas are poorly differentiated. So remember, these invasive carcinomas are poorly differentiated invasive carcinoma. Poorly differentiated invasive carcinoma, and what will be a characteristic immunohistochemical examination of the Paget's disease of the breast? Right, characteristic immunohistochemical examination of Paget's disease of the breast, they will be estrogen receptor negative, and HER2 new will be having overexpression. So they will be having overexpression of HER2 new. So as we can see that what is characteristic of Paget's disease, they are estrogen receptor negative, and they will be estrogen receptor is negative, HER2 new will be having overexpression, right? So by seeing this thing, we can easily make it out ki what will be prognosis. So they will be having poor prognosis, or you can say bad prognosis, right? So they will be having poor prognosis or bad prognosis, right? So this is about Paget's disease. So in summary, I would like to say that it is a rare presentation, 1 to 4% of the 1 to 4% of the breast cancer, as you can see that 1 to 4% of the breast cancer will be presenting with this. There will be resemblance like a eczema because of the erythematous scaly eruptions along with pruritus. They are actually a ductal carcinoma in situ type of cancers, and these tumor cells, as you can see, they will be infiltrating into the epidermis without crossing the basement membrane. That is important, without crossing the basement membrane, as you can see in this picture also. Right, light microscopic examination, you will find Paget's disease are the larger cells, abundant pale cytoplasm, nucleus with prominent nucleoli, as you can see in this microscopic examination. So if you look at this microscopic examination, these are the normal cells, right? And what we are observing here in this area, what I am marking here in this area, I am showing you, these are all Paget's cells, right? All Paget's cells. And what you are observing in these tumor cells, they are having abundant pale cytoplasm. They are having abundant pale cytoplasm. So abundant pale cytoplasm. And if you look at the individual tumor cells, for example, if you look at this individual tumor cell, you can notice there is a prominent nucleoli also, right? So this pale abundant cytoplasm and prominent nucleoli will be present. And when you will see immunohistochemical examination of these Paget's disease, you will find they are estrogen receptor positive, and HER2 new overexpression will be seen, and that is why they will be carrying poor